Welcome back to Calcando. In this episode, I'll demonstrate how to use data merge to move a graphic to a precise point. This example uses a blood pressure graph and a graphic that marks the result of the recipient. As I cycle from record to record, note that the position of the target on the graph changes, along with the category headline and the paragraph below. Also notice that the paragraph below is changing entirely. Not one word here and there, but the entire paragraph. This example is created using InDesign only for the layout and Excel for the data. No third-party database plugins were used to create this example. There are no links apart from the database itself, and no images have been linked to the database. So how are these techniques created? In this episode, I'll reveal the technique for moving the graphic. The technique for swapping the paragraph will be explained in another episode. Let's navigate to a version of the file where the mechanics are a little easier to see. This file has only the graph in the background and what looks like some large arrows in the foreground. These arrows are the key to the technique and are accomplished by using the font called Chartwell Bars, available from FontFont. If I change the font to Myriad Pro, for example, you can see that this is just type. In the original example, they were given no fill or stroke so that they could not be seen. Chartwell Bars is one of several fonts in the Chartwell family that cleverly uses ligatures to create several kinds of graphs using whole numbers. Unlike the other fonts in the series, Chartwell Bars can turn the numbers 1 to 1000 into a graph, whereas the other fonts in the series can only use the whole numbers from 1 to 100. The first arrow is used to move the diastolic pressure and uses the diastolic field from the database. Because this has to move up and down and the type moves from left to right, this text box has been rotated negative 90 degrees. The text box is also aligned to the bottom in the text box options. The arrow in this text box is used to move the systolic pressure. Because this does move from left to right, there is no need to rotate this text box. So that this arrow moves in relation to the first arrow, it is anchored to the first arrow as an inline graphic. The target itself is also anchored to the end of the line, but positioned at the top of the text frame to be in the correct position. To determine the font size of the arrows was trial and error. One way is to make a ruler with known points and experiment with the font size until a correct size is found. So that's how this technique was created. Make sure to watch the next video to see how the paragraph swapping was accomplished. That's it for the video. You can get in touch with me via Twitter at Calcando, check out the blog calcando.com, and see my articles at indesignsecrets.com, as well as all of the usual terrific content. Till we meet again, I'll see you later. Lastly for this video, I would like to pay tribute to my old colleague Vas Spagnolo, who passed away recently. Apart from being a gifted designer and a true professional, he was a wonderful person who put his family first, and we will all miss him dearly. It was an honour and a privilege to work with him. Rest in peace, Vas.